at this point it doesn't matter what you have done in past 2, 3, 4 or whatever number of years. ये भूल जाओ कि हमारी तो 11th बर्बाद हो गई, हमने तो NCERT नहीं पढ़ी. At this point none of this matters. So pull yourself out of that guilt, that negativity. Now it's high time to buckle up and start your game. Hey guys, I'm Srishti and in this video I'm going to share how I revised complete 11th and 12th in just 1 month. In my last video where I have shared my journey, usme maine same cheez ka zikr kiya hai ki how things didn't go as planned. Ho sakta hai ki aapke mann mein bhi aise hi doubt aa rahe ho ki ab ho payega ya nahi. So the first and the most important thing that you need to do is to focus ki ab aage kya hai. ये लास्ट के दिन ही डिसाइड करेंगे योर फेट, दैट इज योर रैंक इन नीट एग्जाम. सो सबसे पहले अपने आप में कॉन्फिडेंस लाओ कि हमसे हो पाएगा और इसी बार में होगा. क्लियर द कटर अराउंड यू, इनसाइड यू एंड देन स्टार्ट. नाउ व्हाट यू नीड टू डू इज प्लान. अपनी सारी बुक्स लेके आओ एंड बाय बुक्स आई मीन NCERT, जितनी भी रेफरेंस बुक है सबको अभी साइड कर दो. Now open the book and mark out the chapters जो आपने complete कर रखे हैं subject wise. Whatever is left is going to be in your to-do list. Remember you don't need to make a timetable, you need to make a checklist for each day. This is how I made it. So this is how my checklist look like. यहाँ पे जो लिखा हुआ है these are dates. So ये जो 3 लिखा है this is 3rd of June. Okay, 17 जुलाई को मेरा exam था. This is 3rd of June, 4th, 5th. ऐसे करके एक-एक chapter आपको ऐसा ही आपको एक चेकलिस्ट बनाना है पहले ही कि 3 तारीख को मुझे ये 3 चैप्टर करने, 4 को ये 3, इस तरह से एटलीस्ट 3 चैप्टर शुड बी देयर डेली. ये मत सोचना कि हमसे 3 चैप्टर एक दिन में नहीं हो पाएगा, बिल्कुल हो पाएगा. यू हैव टू डू इट नाउ. नाउ अब करने कैसे हैं ये 3 चैप्टर्स, दिस इज व्हाट आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू. फॉर बायोलॉजी जस्ट रीड NCERT, नथिंग एल्स, जस्ट NCERT. Give a nice thorough reading and learn side by side and mark those things जो कि आपको याद नहीं हो रही है so that you can revise it later in case you have time left. Okay, so just now I have talked about the importance of NCERT because NCERT is the backbone of NEET. So I was in search of something which will help you retain the NCERT concepts well, and that is when I found this app called as MemoNEET app. Let me tell you that 96/100 question asked in NEET 2022, yes, the year I gave the exam, were directly from this MemoNEET app. They have proved this on their app, and more than 30,000 questions which have taken directly from NCERT is there. And not only for biology, each reaction, each formula in MemoNEET app has been framed in 3 types of question, which is very interesting. First, you will see flashcard which will help you revise and memorize the concepts very fastly. Then you have this match the elements with the right expansion. This helps you to understand the meaning. And then you have to figure out the right equation from the jumbled words. The jumbled word question, the DAG drop question, the match type question will make the MCQ practice interesting and highly interactive. Now, MemoNEET has a very interesting repeat technology. So if you study a question, it will ring a notification for you to practice the same question on the first day, then on the 3rd day, the 5th day and the 8th day in a spaced repetitive manner. And if you study a question and get it wrong, it will come again and again number of times until you get it right. You also have this fun and interactive way of learning like podcasts, you have crossword puzzles and you also have memes. Who doesn't love that? Now MemoNEET series is 100% NCERT based. It is so good because we know that NEET comes from NCERT. And you can solve subject wise and full length test series. I will talk about mock tests in later part of this video. Now, 3 lakhs plus students have downloaded this app and have practiced more than 20 million questions. So if you're a person who is bored to practice NCERT, then MemoNEET is the correct app for you. You can use my code Srishti300 to get ₹300 off on the offer. Now for physics, go through your notes and revise your formula sheet. Now, if you don't have notes, you don't have formula sheet, it's time to go and watch the one shot lecture. Not like a 20 minute video, only a good one shot, like a 1 hour, 2 hour, जिसमें आपके concepts भी clear हो जाएं, जो major concepts है, and you get all the formulas and their applications. Now, you don't need to make notes from these lectures, you just need to write down all the formulas that have come across the complete lecture. Now you have made your formula sheet, now you solve at least 20 PYQs, okay, and go in like a reverse order while solving it. That is, first 2022 ka solve karo, fir 2021, then 2020, and go like that past 20 years at least you have to solve it. See, now coming on to chemistry. For chemistry again, inorganic, just read NCERTs. Apply all the same tactics that I told you for biology. You can totally avoid solving question for biology as well as for inorganic chemistry. So physical chemistry, do the same as physics. But here there's a change that not only your formula should be clear, your concept should also be clear. Because physical chemistry mein se questions can be asked from anywhere. Focus on both and solve PYQs. For organic, nothing is more important than your notes. Second thing, make a list of all the named reactions. That is very, very important. ठीक है, half of organic chemistry में बस named reactions पूछते हैं, तो named reaction की list होनी चाहिए and revise it again and again and again. Now for all the subjects, go in a chronological order, but you can do these chapters together. They will take less time. First is do gravitation with electrostatics. So once you have done gravitation class 11th complete करके next chapter electrostatics complete कर लेना 12th की. Number 2, do ray optics first and then do wave optics along with SHM and wave of class 11th. After you have done all this, you have completed all the chapters in your checklist. Now you need to do solve mock test. कितने mock test देने? Depends on the time कि आपको कितना time अब बचा है. If more than 10 days are left, I will suggest you go for part mock test. मतलब 11th class का आधा mock test, फिर बाकी आधा, फिर 12th का आधा, बाकी 12th का आधा. And every time you solve a mock test, jot down the topics जो आपके weak रह गए हैं. और time बचा है, then master the weak topics. I will show you. See, मैंने यहाँ पे जो चेकलिस्ट बनाई है, यहाँ पे मैंने रिवर बोट लिखा है क्योंकि मैं रिवर बोट वाले क्वेश्चन में बहुत गलती करती थी. ये मेरे वीक टॉपिक्स हैं. ठीक है, पावर करंट, करंट वाले चैप्टर में यहाँ पे गलती हो रही थी. जब मेरा पूरा सिलेबस खत्म हो गया, मुझे पता है कि मेरे पास पूरा टाइम अभी बचा है, ये गलतियां मैंने अपने पार्ट मॉक टेस्ट से ढूंढ ली है. ठीक है, क्योंकि जब आप फुल सिलेबस मॉक टेस्ट देते हो तो आपको उतने वीक पॉइंट्स नहीं पता चलेंगे, क्योंकि इतना बड़ा चैप्टर एक क्वेश्चन गलत होने से वो वीक पॉइंट नहीं होता. जब आप सेम ही टॉपिक का 3-4 क्वेश्चन गलत कर रहे हैं तो उसको वीक पॉइंट कहते हैं. दैट इज वाई पार्ट मॉक टेस्ट आर इंपॉर्टेंट. तो अगर टाइम है तो प्लीज गिव पार्ट मॉक टेस्ट. 11th क्लास का आधा, या यू कैन डू व्हाट आई डिड वाज 1/4 of 11th, then 1/4 of 11th. 11th का मैंने 4 दिए थे, 12th के मैंने 2 दिए थे, because I know my 12th is strong. Master all these weak topics, then jump on to the full mock test. अगर आपका time नहीं बचा है, then directly you can jump on to the full syllabus mock test. Try to solve at least 2 mock tests daily. अगर नहीं हो पा रहा है तो at least try 3 mock tests in 2 days. Okay? And you will see yourself improving day by day. And one thing more, don't try कि आप हर mock test के पहले पूरा ही syllabus revise कर सकें. ठीक है, but एक बार हर mock test देने के पहले अपनी formula sheet जो आपने बनाई है वो flip कर लें, जो named reaction की list बनाई है वो flip कर लें, biology में जो चीज़ें mark की थी जो याद नहीं हो पाई थी वो देख लें. ये चीज़ें आपको हर mock test के पहले देखनी है. And by the end you will see कि आपकी formulas आपके tips पे हैं, named reaction एकदम fluent हो गए हैं, और जो चीज़ें आपको याद नहीं हो रही थी वो एकदम अच्छे से याद हो गई हैं. And you will see your marks improving test by test. Don't go in a hurry कि नहीं आ रहे, नहीं आ रहे. आएंगे, बिल्कुल आएंगे. जितने आ रहे हैं, you try to improve them. If you have any doubt regarding this, do feel free to ask me in the comment section. All the best. So at last, I would like to thank MemoNeet app for sponsoring this video, and I would like to thank all of you for this 1K family. I am very, very grateful to all of you, and keep your love and support like this, and I will see you soon, very, very soon actually, in my next video. Till then, keep learning.